So far, we've been using the default atlases of the Con toolbox, which can be found in the folder con/ROIs. For example, the file atlas.nai contains parcellations derived from the Harvard-Oxford Cortical Atlas, as well as cerebellum parcellations. Each of these files has a companion TXT file that indicates what label belongs to which parcellation. If you open the file atlas.txt, for example, you would see these lines, and these correspond to the seeds that you see during the first and second level analyses. But what if you want to use your own atlas? In that case, you would need to create a series of ROIs combined into a single image, in which each ROI is indexed by a separate number. You can do this with Fossilize, which requires installing FSL. If you don't already have FSL installed, click on the link in the description box below. When you open Fossilize, the first thing you should do is click on File, Add from Standard, and select the image MNI-152T1-2mm. Then, from the Tools menu, select Edit Mode, and click on the sheet of paper on the left-hand panel to create a copy of the underlying image. This is like tracing paper that we can draw our masks on. Now let's say that we wanted to create a very simple atlas that contains only four ROIs, one in the ventromedial prefrontal cortex, one in the posterior cingulate, one in the dorsal anterior cingulate, and one in the perigenual cingulate. To make this simple, let's create a 5mm sphere in the general area of each of these regions. Click on Select Mode and highlight the Search by Intensity button, the 3D button, and the Sphere button, and then change the search radius to 5. Left-click in the approximate center of each area we just listed, and then click on the Fill button in the panel to the left to fill those voxels with whatever the fill value is. When we create the next ROI, let's say in the posterior cingulate cortex, we can increase the fill value to 2, so that the voxels in that region will have a value of 2. And we do this for the rest of the ROIs. This may take some time, but when you're done, click on the button next to the mask to save the atlas. I recommend also creating a folder called ROIs and saving the atlas into that directory. In this case, I'm going to call it Andy ROIs, but you can call it whatever you want. I would then create a text file called andyrois.txt. The first entry would correspond to the ROI that has a value of 1, the second row would correspond to the ROI that has a value of 2, and so on. I had already written this text file beforehand, but you can create one using any text editor. When you finish creating the file, open up Con, go to the Setup tab, and click the plus sign when you hover your mouse over the ROIs column, and then call the ROI whatever you want. Then in the Select ROI Definition Files menu on the right, navigate to where you stored your ROI and select it. If you've already pre-processed your data, you can click on Done to rerun the setup, and you'll also need to rerun the denoising as well. You should then see your ROIs in the First Level tab, and you will be able to use them as seeds, clicking on the arrow to move them from all ROIs to selected seeds sources. Notice that the perigenual ACC and PCC regions highlight the default mode network, which suggests that the ROI import was successful. If you want to create an atlas based on a meta-analysis map from a site like Neurosynth, here's one way to do it. In this case, let's say that we downloaded a map representing common activations for the term mentalizing. If you look at the map using Fossilize, you will notice that there are many clusters all over the brain. To make this more manageable, let's see where the peaks are by using FSL's cluster command. Type cluster-t6-i mentalizing association test. This will return any clusters that have a z value greater than 6. This is arbitrary, but it makes the data more manageable. Then we write down the coordinates for the top few clusters that we're interested in. Again, this is up to you, but let's say I wanted to focus on just the top three clusters. I would write down these x, y, and z coordinates, which, by the way, roughly correspond to the frontal pole, the precuneus, and the left angular gyrus. For the rest of the video, I'll leave this running while I show you how I would do the rest of these steps, using the same methods we used in the first part of the video. I don't have any commentary to provide while I'm doing it, so you can just watch it at your own pace. I will be fading out and fading back in if there's a long segment, such as rerunning the pre-processing in the contour box. But other than that, I'll leave it up to you to watch this, and I'll also put on some music in the background.